An Academy. Let's crack it.
Yes. So let us start with the first one. Image A, image B, and image C. Telegram page group name is Dr. Nikita's Rad Synapse. Okay, it is Dr. Nikita's Rad Synapse. Now identify the organisms here. It is A, B, and C. Which are these organisms? First of all, do you see all of them are gram positive? All of them are gram negative. One of them is gram positive. Which is gram positive, gram negative? Are all of these gram positive, gram negative? What are these? Tell me about A, B, C. Yes. All of these are basically your gram positive cocci. Okay, these are your gram positive cocci. Remember, gram positive are purple in color. Gram negative organisms are pink in color. So you see this purple organisms, these are the purple organisms, the purple organisms. All these are gram positive cocci. So first one, you see this gram positive cocci in clusters. This is your staphylococcus. Here you see gram-positive diplococci, lanceolate shape, jo bolte hai. It is your diplococci, lanceolate shape. That is your Streptococcus pneumoniae. Okay, that's your Streptococcus pneumoniae. And here you see gram-positive cocci in chains. So this is your Streptococcus pyogenes. Okay, this is your Streptococcus pyogenes, the most important organisms that we need to know. Okay, staph, Streptococcus pneumoniae, Streptococcus pyogenes, ye hai. So now we are going to see the flow chart for your gram-positive organisms. I know you people might not be able to read this. We have gram-positive bacilli, cocci and branching filaments and all. Uske hum isko separate karte hain. So the first one, very, very important, is your gram-positive cocci. Okay, we have your gram-positive cocci. The first test in your gram-positive cocci, basically to differentiate staphylococcus versus streptococcus, it is your catalase test. Okay, it's your catalase. Staphylococcus is catalase positive, streptococcus is catalase negative. Please remember that. So how do we remember that is? How do we remember that is? Ek minute. So we remember that there's a cat by the name of Staffy. Okay, suppose you have a pet cat whose name is Staffy. So remember Staffy cat, that is Staffy, staphylococcus is catalase positive. So streptococcus is catalase negative. Now let us tackle staphylococcus first. So now in staphylococcus, when you want to further differentiate, you have to do coagulase test. Okay, coagulase test. Catalase positive, coagulase positive is your staph aureus. So remember, aureus is all positive. Aureus is all positive. That is catalase positive and it is coagulase positive as well. Yes. Then when you want to differentiate between the other two, Staphylococcus saprophyticus and epidermidis, you have to do novobiocene sensitivity. Okay, that is your novobiocene sensitivity test that we have to do. Staph epidermidis is your novobiocene sensitive. Staph saprophyticus is your novobiocene resistant. So novobiocene, yaad rakhna ki jaise ek ointment hai novobiocene, you apply on the skin, that is epidermis, and it kills your epidermidis. So staph epidermidis is sensitive to your ointment of novobiocene. Okay, novobiocene ointment acts on the epidermidis, not on the saprophyticus. Saprophyticus, most important is what? Saprophyticus. Saprophyticus causes UTI in your young sexually active females. That is very, very important to remember. Okay, UTI in young females, that is staph saprophyticus. So everyone is clear with this? Everyone is clear with the staphylococcus ka flow chart? Right, so you have to first do the catalase. All of them will be catalase positive. Staph aureus is all positive, that is catalase coagulase positive. Epidermidis, saprophyticus are coagulase negative. So you do novobiocene. Epidermidis is sensitive to novobiocene. Going to the next one, that is your now coming to streptococcus. So that is your catalase negative. It will be streptococcus will be in pairs or chains. Pairs diplococci is your Streptococcus pneumoniae, chains is pyogenes. Remember, most important, these ones. So now you differentiate them based on the hemolysis pattern. अल्फा बीटा और गामा हिमोलिसिस. सो गामा हिमोलिसिस मीन्स बेसिकली देर इज नो हिमोलिसिस. ओके अल्फा मीन्स इट इज पार्शियल हिमोलिसिस, इट गिव्स अ ग्रीन कलर. बीटा इज योर कंप्लीट हिमोलिसिस, इट मेक्स द ब्लड अगार क्लियर. सो एंड दिस इज नो हिमोलिसिस. Now, in your alpha hemolytic, which are the streptococcus coming in your alpha, you have your viridans and pneumococci. Okay, viridans and pneumococci come in your alpha hemolytic. So, how do we differentiate? We do the optogen sensitivity and the bile solubility test. So, your streptococcus pneumoniae is optogen sensitive and it is bile soluble. Okay, and it is bile soluble. So the trick to remember this is, so remember for your antibiotics in your streptococcus, remember overpass, and that means your optogen is viridans resistant and it is pneumococcus sensitive. So optogen is overpass, that is it is viridans resistant and it is pneumococcus sensitive. Optogen and your bile solubility, they go together. That means pneumococcus cannot grow in bile, wo usme dissolve ho jayega, bile soluble hai. So optogen sensitive, remember it is overpass, that is viridans resistant, pneumococcus is sensitive. Viridans is not capsulated, pneumococcus is capsulated. What is the appearance of the colonies that we get in your streptococcus pneumoniae? What appearance do we get? Drotsman colonies hoti hai, Drotsman colonies, carom coin colonies, that is what we get with your pneumococcus, Drotsman or carom coin. Viridans mein you have streptococcus mutans and mites. Okay, mutans and mites. Then in your beta hemolytic, basically then you have your group A, you have group B. So for that you do your bacitracin sensitivity. So beta hemolytic ke liye we do bacitracin sensitivity and PYR status. It is positive in your group A, that is group A, which is your streptococcus pyogenes. We know that group B streptococcus, where have we read about group B streptococcus? GBS, आपने पढ़ा होगा. What is that organism causing? Very good. It is meningitis in the newborn. Newborn neonates mein meningitis. You have to remember Streptococcus agalactiae, that is group B. And the other one is your neonatal meningitis ke important two causes at least pata hona chahiye. Ya teen bolo, jo bhi bolo. You have listeria, very important. You have group B streptococcus and you can have E. coli. Okay, these are the organisms in your neonatal. So group B streptococcus is your neonatal meningitis. It will be bacitracin resistant. Okay, it will be bacitracin resistant. And your pyogenes is your group A. That is your bacitracin sensitive. So for this, the mnemonic to remember is B and BRAS. Okay, remember B, BRAS. That is bacitracin ki test ke liye group B wala is resistant, A wala is sensitive. What do we have in A? In A we have streptococcus pyogenes. Streptococcus is your group A streptococcus. It is beta hemolytic. It is beta hemolytic group A streptococcus. Okay, so remember it is B, BRAS to be remembered. Next one, gamma is your gamma is basically your enterococcus wala isme aata hai, enterococcus, non-enterococcus. You have streptococcus bovis. Now enterococcus, as the term says, intestine mein grow karne wala, intestine mein there is bile. So it grows in your NaCl and it grows in bile. No hemolysis, it grows in bile. It can grow in 6.5% NaCl. Theek hai, jo basically intestine mein whatever we have, that is your enterococcus. Your non-enterococcus, that is streptococcus bovis, which is now called as streptococcus galloliticus, which causes, what does it cause? Infective endocarditis along with your colorectal cancer. So you need to do colonoscopy in these patients. So infective endocarditis, colon cancer, important. It does not grow in your 6.5% NaCl. Okay, So Entero will grow in bile and 6.5% NaCl. That is your Enterococcus faecalis, Enterococcus faecium. All right. So that was about your Streptococcus. Okay. That was about your Streptococcus. Quickly revise karte hain. So Streptococcus is basically alpha, beta, gamma hemolytic. Alpha wale mein, we do the optogen sensitivity and the bile solubility test. The mnemonic is overpass. Beta mein, it is basically group A, group B. You have the mnemonic, which is B, bras. Okay. A wala is bacitracin sensitive. It is your Streptococcus pyogenes. B wala is resistant. You have your Streptococcus agalacti. Gamma wala, no hemolysis. It grows in bile, which grows in 6.5% NaCl, is your intestine wala, Enterococcus. That is your Enterococcus. Okay.